हाँ उपाय
गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल, गुड मॉर्निंग, हाउ आर यू ऑल? गुड, ओह वेरी गुड, ओह वाओ, नाइस नाइस टू हियर दिस. आई विल जॉइन द व्हाट्सएप ग्रुप. Is there anyone who is still not on WhatsApp and Google Classroom? But Google, are you all joined for Google Classroom?
Yes, yes.
Sure?
Yes.
Oh, great. If not, please do it today. So where were you? In our Google Classroom, right? Yeah, I'm telling you in what is our class chat, that also I'm telling you. 7th B. It is 7th B, right? Oh, we should be 37 child, right? And we are still less over there. That means many of you are not joined. Do it so. Okay. So today, those who have not joined, kindly do that.
Yes, Mr. Cooper, so that speaker is not opening.
What is not opening? What is not opening? Why you want the screenshot to open? You have to only join classroom, that's it. What
do you only send the
screenshot? I am sent so that those who are there, their name are in that list. If your name is not in that list, means you have to join. Got it? Got it or not? One by one. Say, do I say something?
Ma'am, and the first one you sent the definition of integers also, you said no integer available file is in owner's hash.
Yeah, yesterday I checked. After that,
Good morning to all.
Good morning, sir.
Good morning, sir.
What was the last thing we dealt with in the previous class?
Sir, we calculated the minimum force required to start rolling in a body.
On a horizontal surface.
Yes, sir, for a disc.
For a disc. Okay. Did we deal with hinges?
Yes, sir.
We have covered up that.
Did we deal with a body rolling on an accelerating plank?
No, sir.
Okay. We'll have to start from there. Till now, the body was pulling on ground. Till now, the body was rolling on ground. Now, once again, I will take a test. Lower surface is smooth. Here, this surface, friction is sufficient to prevent slipping. This is of radius r and mass m. The plank is having an acceleration of capital A. Technically, I should give you the force on. I'm just decreasing one equation. If I give you the force here, what will happen? That force minus the friction is capital M into capital A. If instead of giving you the acceleration directly, I give you the force here. That force minus friction is capital M into capital. But I decrease that equation. Now you're asking me, find the acceleration of center of mass of the disk. Find the acceleration of COM of disk. Obviously, translational dynamic equation, rotational dynamic equation, and constraints. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Now, on this, friction will be in the forward direction. Do you have any other horizontal force on the disk?
No, sir.
Sir, pseudo force.
I'm going with respect to ground.
Okay, sir.
Friction is equal to m into a. A will be the acceleration of
center of mass.
A will be the acceleration of
center of mass.
Translational dynamic equation. Second is rotational dynamic equation. Torque about center of mass is F into R. Torque about the center of mass is F into R. That is giving me anti-clockwise torque. That means A, you have taken this way. Alpha, you can take, you have taken this way. Who told you that I have taken A in the forward direction? Your first equation. Who told you that I have taken alpha in anti-clockwise direction? Your second equation. F into R is anti-clockwise torque. So alpha will be anti-clockwise. Mr square by 2 into alpha. Moment of inertia of a disk is Mr square by 2. F is equal to Mr alpha by translational dynamic equation, rotational dynamic equation. Constraints. The problem is mainly taken to explain constraints. Acceleration of this point and this point should be the same. This point and this point acceleration should be the same. What is the acceleration of this point? Acceleration of the point with respect to center of mass plus acceleration of center of mass with respect to ground is acceleration of point P with respect to ground. Acceleration of point P with respect to center of mass is R alpha.
Yes, sir.
Plus acceleration of center of mass with respect to ground is A. You took alpha in anti-clockwise, so R alpha was in forward direction. You took A in the forward direction, so it is sum of both. Here, it will not be zero. It will not be zero. It should be the same as that of this. Capital A, the most important thing in this equation is the constraint. Generally, till now, I was taking the velocity or acceleration of this, and I was equating it to zero because it was on the ground. Today it is on a truck, which itself is accelerating with an acceleration of capital A.
Yes.
Alpha plus A is the acceleration of this point with respect to ground, which should be the same as the acceleration of the truck. Alpha is capital A minus small a by R. So F is mr by 2 capital A minus small a by R. Substituting this F in the first equation. Ma by 2 minus Ma by 2 should be equal to Ma. A by 2 is 3a by 2. Small a is 8 by 3 is the acceleration of center of mass of the cylinder if it is rolled. Acceleration of center of mass of the cylinder if it is rolling. And you told me here friction is sufficient to prevent slipping. Till now all examples you took were on ground. So you were equating this acceleration to zero. Here it is on a truck, which itself is accelerating. So equate this acceleration to this particular point's acceleration. Now, I have a requirement from you people. Take this down and solve the same problem. with respect to an observer on capital. When you keep an observer on capital N, you need to introduce pseudo force?
Yes, sir.
So using that procedure and final answer, make sure that you're getting the same answer. I will give you 5 minutes. Take this down and solve with respect to capital M.
Done, sir.
One minute.
10, sir.
So you will solve with respect to observer, right?
Pardon?
You will solve with respect to observer, right?
Yeah.
So if we are getting minus a by 3, though, therefore it's wrong, right?
Switch off your mic for a second. Now listen, you are solving the problem with respect to an observer standing here. So I should put a pseudo force of M into capital A. Agreed?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Then the question is, will this man see this going ahead or backwards? I actually don't know. With respect to ground, I can tell you center of mass is going ahead because there is only one frictional force acting. With respect to this man, is that body going backwards or forward? I don't know. So I assume it goes in the forward direction. For your information, it doesn't. Because I already solved the problem, I know I'm telling you. But when you're starting the problem, you will not know. So let me take the wrong direction. F minus the pseudo force is M into AR. That means you have taken AR in the forward direction. F minus M is M into AR. That means according to you, relative acceleration of center of mass of the disk with respect to this observer is in the forward direction. So far, so good?
Yes,
sir. Yes, sir.
Because either I can take about this point or center of mass. How will you take about this point here that's accelerating? Yes, it has same acceleration as capital A. I took the Sudoku. So I can take the torque about point of contact. But to avoid confusion, I'm taking torque about center of mass. F into R is I into alpha. F into R anticlockwise is I into alpha. F is MR alpha by 2. F is MR alpha by 2. Translational dynamic equation, rotational dynamic equation. Constraints. Have a look at it. Acceleration of the point with respect to center of mass plus acceleration of center of mass with respect to capital M will be acceleration of the point P with respect to capital M. Acceleration of point P with respect to center of mass plus acceleration of center of mass with respect to capital M is acceleration of point P with respect to capital. Point P with respect to center of mass is R alpha. Acceleration of center of mass with respect to capital M is here. This should be zero. Acceleration of point P with respect to capital M should be zero.
Yes, sir.
So alpha is minus AR by capital R. MR by 2. Minus AR by capital R. Substituting this friction here, minus MR by 2, minus MA is equal to m into a. A is equal to minus 3ar by 2, or ar is minus 2a by 3. When I got a negative sign here, that itself told me that either ar or alpha have taken the wrong direction. But I will not change anything instantaneously. I'll let the problem be completed. It will take care of itself. Ar is minus 2a by 3. This man will see the sector of mass going in the backward direction with minus 2a by 3. How do you know that this and the previous answer are the same? This is 2a by 3 with respect to capital M plus acceleration of capital M with respect to ground. Do I get back a by 3?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Take it down till here.
Taking talk about center of mass and not about p.
Any time talk about center of mass is the safest. That's what we have learned, right?
Yes, sir.
So why do you Got question it. The fact that center of mass should be? When will I change away from center of mass? This is an advantage. Even if I take about point of contact, I'll get torque due to one force. Whether I take about center of mass, I'm getting torque due to one force. So why will I shift from center of mass? But if you want, you can take the torque about point of contact as well, because you introduced a solar force. Can I rub the board?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Do you people remember the concept of motion in a vertical circle taught in circular motion?
Yes, sir.
Now listen to this question, you will attempt this. This is a fixed track. This is a fixed track of radius capital R. There is a solid sphere of mass m, radius small. Friction on the inner side of the track is sufficient to prevent slipping. Friction on inner side of track is sufficient to prevent slipping. Find U minimum so that it completes a vertical circle. Is asking you find U minimum so that it completes a vertical circuit. Remember, body is rolling.
Rolling.
So when the sphere is on the horizontal plane, there is also friction at that.
There is sufficient friction all throughout the inner side of the track.
Okay, sir.
All throughout the body is rolling.
Sir, is U constant?
How can that be? It will not be, but you are making me spill the beans on the problem. You are making, asking me for the hint. Body is going up. How will U be constant?
Okay.
So can you just write the final answer?
I'll give a hint here. Wait for 1 second. I'll finish up.
Okay, sir.
So can you please give 2 minutes more?
Okay.
Sir, is the answer root 27 GR by 7?
27, probably yes.
Sir, I am getting it in terms of small r and capital R.
Yeah, capital. Radius will be capital R minus small r. Radius will be capital R minus small r. Now listen. When the body reaches the topmost point, normal force and mg are acting in the downward direction. What is the condition for a body to complete a vertical circle? The condition is normal force should not become zero till it reaches the topmost point. If the normal force becomes zero somewhere from here, it will not complete a circle. It will go as a projectile motion. So normal force plus mg will provide the required centripetal force. Normal force at the topmost point should become zero, not before that. V root over of g into. Technically, the radius is capital R minus small r. Effective radius from here till here is capital R minus small r. So, this is the velocity I should have at the topmost point. But remember, body is rolling. What is the initial energy? Half mu square plus half ICM omega. What is the final energy? Mg 2 times R minus R. mg 2 times r minus r plus kinetic energy there is half m v square half icm omega rolling body. Here omega is u by r. Here omega is v by r. Potential energy rise from here till here. This height is 2 times r minus r. From here till here, this height is 2 times r minus r. Kinetic energy here is half mv square plus half icm omega. Cancel out half all throughout, multiply with 2 here. Mu square plus 2 by 5 mr square into u square by r square is 4 mg r minus r plus mv square plus 2 by 5 mr square v square by r square. R square will go. This will become 7 by 5 mu square. 4 mg r minus r plus 7 by 5 mv square. What is v? G into r minus r. Canceling out m. Will I get the value of u?
Yes, sir.
Sir, I would doubt. Sir, in the energy conservation, won't we have friction?
Work done by friction is?
Got it, sir.
Zero. So because zero, point zero. Of contact is at rest.
Point of contact,
point
is, moving,
of contact is at rest with
yes,
rest.
Sir, yes, sir.
Perfect.
Excuse me, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, why is it r minus r, sir?
Distance from the center to the center of the body. Body's center of mass is the distance of capital R minus small r. If this is capital R, what will this distance be? Capital R minus small.
So the center of that, it is a small object also. Okay.
Solid sphere ka radius is smaller.
Okay, got it. Thank you.
Sir, over there, how did you get 7 by 5 mg r minus r?
V I substituted. 7 okay, by sir. 5 mg square. V square first equation says substitute.
So, what was the hint in this question?
What was the?
Hint.
Solution diya to hint puch raha hai ye banda.
Okay, sir.
Somebody was asking, will you change? Obviously, you will change. You change it to be at the topmost point. Niche u tha, upar jane tak, it became v.
One minute, wait. Don't erase the work.
So you can erase.
Yes, sir.
Friction will keep varying along the track. Depending on the angle theta, friction will adjust itself to make sure that the body rolls. But on an inclined plane, you are aware that always friction will act up the inclined plane. But ultimately, point of contact is at rest with respect to surface. Now listen to this. This is a trough fixed trough. Right? You have a solid cylinder rolling and released from a height of h. Released from a height of h. This side of the track is sufficiently rough to prevent slipping. This side of the track till here is sufficiently rough to prevent slipping. Right side of the track is smooth. This side is rough to prevent slipping. This side is smooth. Is the situation clear till here?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The question asked is, on the right side, will this solid cylinder rise to a height greater than H, lesser than H, or equal to H? On the right side, will the solid cylinder rise to a height greater than H, lesser than H, or equal to H?
So, can we tell the answer?
Yeah.
So less than it.
Lesser than it.
Lesser than it.
Because it's an inclined plane and it's smooth, sir. So it will not be able to roll.
So friction will do work now.
Friction will not.
Oh, sorry. Friction not there only. Friction.
Sir, equal to H, no?
Yes, sir. Equal to H.
Equal to H.
Friction will not do.
Lesser than H. Listen carefully.
Yes, sir. Lesser than
H. Lesser than H. The answer is me. This body, when it comes down, mgh will be equal to half icm omega square plus half mv square. One second. One second, just wait.
Yes, sir, no problem.
Now listen. This body, when it rolls down till here, its potential energy converts into kinetic energy. Do you all agree with that?
Yes, sir.
Kinetic energy for a rolling body is half ICM omega squared plus half MV squared?
Yes, sir.
Now when it is going up the other side, omega will remain constant. Omega will remain constant thereafter. Why will omega remain constant? There is no torque because friction is the only force which produces torque. There is no torque, no alpha. If there is no alpha, omega remain constant. So this will remain with the body. Only this will go into mgh dash. On the right hand side, it will come to a height of h dash. Omega will remain with the body constant. So the body is spinning as it is going up. There is no friction. Matlab, there is no torque. Mg and normal force are passing through the center of mass. Torque is zero. And you remember, recollect, on an inclined plane, friction is the only force which produces torque. Friction is zero. Torque is zero. Alpha is zero. Omega is constant. So this will remain with the body. What is converted into gravitational potential energy? That will be only mgh dash. What is converted into gravitational potential energy? Mgh dash. H dash is lesser than h.
So, sir, you are saying at h dash height, the ball will stay at h dash and it will roll like this only. It will keep rolling there.
Right hand side, why will it roll? Smooth incline
rolling hoga. It is at the same point now.
At the topmost point?
It will be spinning like it will only stay at that point only.
Which point here?
H dash, H dash.
Why will it not come down? Wahan par hinge kiya hai aapne?
Okay, sir.
But that is not a part of our question. Our question is right hand side to what height will it go?
Less than h.
H dash will be lesser than h. Uske baad wahi par rahega, niche aayega, unnecessary confusions. We ask you to what height will it rise? After which, for sure, it will again come back. But even when it is coming back, it will have the same omega in the same direction.
Okay, sir, got it.
So basically, a smooth surface rolling is not providing any support, so the height is less, no, as velocity has been.
The statement is wrong. Rolling providing support is rocket science for me. What do you mean by rolling providing support? Rolling na friction hai na torque. Rolling need to be supported by friction. Ulta bol rahe ho. रोलिंग किसको सपोर्ट प्रोवाइड करेगा? किसी को नहीं।
वेलोसिटी कम होगी ना क्योंकि हाफ आईसीएम ओमेगा स्क्वायर कुछ काम का तो है नहीं।
वी घट रहा है मगर ओमेगा कांस्टेंट रहेगा। सो वी इक्वल टू आर ओमेगा रिलेशन विल नॉट सस्टेन। सो बॉडी फ्रॉम हियर टिल हियर इज नॉट रोलिंग व्हिच वी आर अवेयर ऑफ। स्मूथ इंक्लाइन प्लेन पर रोलिंग नहीं होगा। वी आर अवेयर ऑफ इट। यस और नो?
यस सर।
So, sir, since the body is not rolling, the high ICM omega square will not convert to potential energy, right?
Right. That will remain with the body as it is.
Okay, sir.
Omega will remain constant.
No, there, sir.
Kinematics of rolling. Now, when a body is rolling, I wish I could draw identical circles. It is the same body, so it should look identical.
Yes, sir.
I will put a small paint mark on the lowermost point of the disc. After some time, when the body is rolling, this paint mark will reach the topmost point.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
After some time, this paint reached here, it reached here, it reached here, it came down in one complete cycle. In one complete cycle, this is the way that point will move. There is no slipping. So what will this displacement be? 2 pi r?
Yes,
there
sir.
Is no slipping. Yes, it's like opening up the carpet. There is no slipping. So the displacement is 2 pi r. But what will the distance traveled be? This will be a cycloidal path. Let me make you visualize this from a wheel. 1 second, have patience, let me open this.
Points will have more interesting paths that we will also track. In order to track the motion, we will use two techniques. One of those is long exposure photography, which will just show the end paths of the lights, and the other is video post-processing, which will attempt to track the light as it moves through the video so you can see how it rolls.
All of the curves traced will belong to the cycloid family of curves. The first curve is traced with the green LED at the spool center. Since the center of the spool should always be one inner radius from the track, the path is traced as a straight line, with slight variations from the curve of the track. The purple LED is between the spool's center and its inner radius. All such points will trace curtate cycloids, which look a bit like elongated sine curves, and will vary depending on the exact distance. The yellow LED is located exactly on the inner radius of the spool. It traces out a cycloid, where you can notice distinct cusps once every rotation. This is when the light has zero velocity, as it is at the no-slip point and instant center of the spool. The next two curves will be prolate cycloids. Prolate cycloids form for any point outside the inner radius and will have similar characteristics. First is the blue LED. Notice that the path starts to curl back on itself. The outermost path is the red LED, which looks similar to that of the blue LED. As the path loops back on itself, you can notice that at some points, this light actually has a negative x component of velocity, even though the entire spool is moving to the right. Finally, we will show all of the curves traced out together. In this way, a full family of cycloid curves can be seen, and intermediate curves are easier to imagine. This should show how seemingly simple things can contain an entire spectrum of interesting phenomena.
Now, we have drawn for only the outermost part of the ring. He showed you different points of the ring slightly when you are coming inside. center of mass will be going along a straight line. Center of mass will be going along a straight line. Now, interestingly, I want to calculate the speed of this rim, this point P. This will be velocity of center of mass. This will be omega. I am interested to know the speed of the particle P, which makes an angle of theta with the vertical line. How do you get the speed? Speed of the particle P with respect to center of mass, I mean rather velocity, plus velocity of center of mass with respect to ground is velocity of the point P with respect to ground. Velocity of the point P with respect to center of mass plus velocity of center of mass with respect to ground will be velocity of point P with respect to ground. Now, this velocity of point P with respect to ground, if I want the magnitude of this, it should be parallelogram law of addition. Velocity of point P with respect to center of mass is r omega. Plus velocity of center of mass is vc. I need the resultant of these both. That is your question. R omega and vcm. Vcm vector I translated here. This angle is pi minus theta. This angle will be pi minus theta, angle between r omega and vcm. So r omega whole square plus vcm whole square plus 2 vcm into r omega into cos of pi minus theta. Parallelogram law of addition between r omega and vcm. Velocity of the point P with respect to center of mass is r omega. Vc with respect to ground. I translated this vector here so that I can take the resultant of these two. If any one of you will ask me how you got this angle to be pi minus theta, and hang you upside down. Now, Vcm is equal to r omega. What is rolling? So this will become Vcm square, Vcm square, 2 Vcm square cos pi minus theta minus cos theta 2 Vc square into 1 minus cos theta will be 2 sin square theta by 2. This will be 2 Vc sin theta by 2. This will be the speed of the particle with respect to ground. Speed of the particle point P with respect to ground. Can I cross verify this? You can. For a ruling body, I know the velocity at the lowermost point and the topmost point. At the lowermost point means what is theta? Zero.
Zero.
Put sine zero.
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 Sine zero is zero. Right?
Yes, sir.
Topmost point. Theta is pi. 2 times Vcm. Sine pi by 2.
1.
Sine pi by 2 will become 1. 1. 2 times Vcm.
Yes, sir.
Take it down till here.
Sir, what subheading should we give this? Like, do we have to give any object rolling of any object?
Kinematics ka continuation. Kinematics of rolling upar likha hua hai.
Okay, sir.
Sir,
uh-huh.
Sir, the diagram is here drawn on top right, sir. In this, sir, what we had tried to provide, I didn't get this.
Yes, sir. You have reconfirmed with this velocity. Comparing with what you know, when the body is rolling, what is the velocity of the point of contact?
Zero on that point.
So how will I get that? Putting theta equal to zero. This point is here, theta is zero. Sine zero is?
Sine zero is zero.
Wonderful. Now at the topmost point, what will theta be?
Pi.
Sine pi by 2 is?
1.
2 times VCM. When the body is rolling, velocity at the topmost point is 2 times vcm, right?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Then, sir.
Noted, sir.
Now the question is, what is the distance traveled by this? How do I get the distance ds by dt will be 2 times vcm sine theta by 2. This was the speed of the particle arbitrary point P. This is the speed. Speed as ds by dt.
Yes, sir.
Ds is 2vc sine omega t by 2 dt. I got dt to the right. And I substituted theta is omega t. Angular displacement is angular velocity into time. Integral ds to vcm is r omega sine of omega t by 2 dt. 0 to 1 complete time period. In one time period you want to know what is the distance, right? S is equal to 2r omega integral sine omega t by 2 dt 0 to 2 pi by omega. How did you get t is 2 pi by omega? T is theta by omega. Theta is 2 pi. T will be one time period. One time period mein theta is 2 pi. Time is angular displacement by angular velocity. When time is one complete time period, angular displacement is 2 pi. Can you complete this simplification?
Sir, can you tell me final answer?
What is the answer you are getting? Cheating कर रहे हो, simplification नहीं करोगे, मुझसे answer पूछ लोगे?
Sir, is it 8R?
8R is correct. Simplify this. You know how to integrate sine theta d theta sine omega t by 2 by omega by 2. Integral of sine omega t by 2 will be cos of omega t by 2 by omega by 2 with a negative.
Noted, sir. One minute.
Sir, wait, just a moment.
So, sir, 8R is the length of that cycloid path?
Is the length of the cycloidal path, yes.
Okay.
बाकी सब्जेक्ट्स
मिलेगा। अरे वो फॉर्म वगैरह
चल रहा है नहीं
Done, sir.
Yes, sir. Noted,
sir. Now, one interesting point in this question. They are interested to know the radius of this small tract. This small tract or radius triangle. Aap circular motion mein bhi kiye the aisa question?
Yes, sir.
Radius of curvature, yes.
Radius of curvature of this circular motion may, if you people remember, you said mg provides the required centripetal force.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Right. Now here the dynamics is slightly different. It's a cycloid. Other than mg, there are normal forces also coming into picture. Is body par yahan par normal force hai?
Yes,
yes, sir.
Tell me something like mg provides the required centripetal force. So what is your requirement here? I wish I could draw a proper circle. You are interested in this radius. Radius of the small element of the cycloid at the topmost. Radius of the small element of the cycloid at the topmost. This is important. Dhyan se suno. If you have one observer standing here and one observer standing here. Are both the observers on inertial frames?
Yes, sir.
Are both the observers on inertial frames?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
So both of them will report the same acceleration for this point. Yes or no?
Yes, sir.
Separate both the accelerations, you will get the answer. I will give you 2 minutes for that. I'll keep you people on mute. Listen to the logic again. There is an observer on the center of mass, there is an observer on the ground. Both of them are on inertial frames. He is at rest, keep moving with uniform speed. Both are on inertial frames implies both will report the same acceleration to this point.
Yes, sir.
Both will report the same acceleration. Now, this is moving with velocity 2 times the velocity of center of mass. Centripetal acceleration as seen by this observer on C will be 2vcm minus vcm whole square by r. 2 times velocity of center of mass minus velocity of center of mass divided by r, v square by r. What is the velocity of this point with respect to center of mass? 2vcm minus vcm whole square by r. Distance between them is r. What will this observer report the centripetal acceleration for this? 2vcm whole square by x. X is the radius. X is the radius. This will be vcm square by r, 4vcm square by x. This man will see this going in a circular track of radius r. This man will see this going in a circular track of radius x. So that's what you have taken. Pura smart move, right?
So, the center of the radius will be on the ground, right?
Center of the radius will be deep inside the ground. This distance is 2r. Radius is 4r. Radius of this will be 4r, deep inside the ground.
Okay, sir.
So, I didn't get how for the person on the ground, the radius will be x.
First one is this.
Yes.
This is
more. So I didn't get the second one, the x wala equation.
X is what you have to calculate. This man will see the velocity of this as 2 times vcm.
Yes, sir.
So according to him, what is the centripetal acceleration? 2 vcm whole square by the radius.
But sir, wouldn't radius be r and not x? Why will it be?
Calculate kya kar rahe ho?
Radius
according to this man is r. What are you calculating in this person?
Okay, sir.
You are calculating that x.
Okay, sir.
If it were r, on simplification, I would have got r.
Okay, sir.
Can I rub the board?
Yes, sir.
Yes.
Next class, we will be dealing with connected bodies by a string. You will have to learn that systematically. You get it, you're on the top of the world. You don't get it, you're nowhere. It's like a line on this side or that side. In general, physics is so. There will be nothing like I understood half the concept. Either you got it or you don't get it. The subject is so. I will not be able to change it for your sake. But that's the way it works. One clarification regarding the part test question. In part test, you had a question where there is a mass moving with 10 meters per second and after collision they ask for certain value. incidentally, they have given some extra information in the question which is wrong. Specifically, octocollision. Because in this question, if you equate the velocities along the tangential direction, velocity of small m along the tangential direction, before and after collision should be the same?
Yes, sir.
Conservation of momentum along x axis, if you solve, you're getting a different answer.
Yes, sir.
They have given certain extra information which destroys the probable validity of the question. That is, when they said it was a perfectly elastic collision, they shouldn't have given this as 4 meters per second. When it is a perfectly elastic collision, using that find out the velocity, you are getting a different value and not 4. They gave you the masses. So use only the condition perfectly elastic collision and solve. You will not get 4 meters per second for this. Hence, that question has been given as bonus. I have conveyed it to the paper setter and I conveyed it to Gautam as well. They are making it a bonus. One more question which has got a problem is, if nothing is told in the question, G will be taken as 9.8 and not 10. That will be wrong to take it as 10. JE people will stick to the nomenclature that G will be 9.8 if nothing is told. Right? G will be 9.8 and not 10. So quite a few people who have taken it as 10 and solved will lose marks for that.
So no right? compromises for the part test if we have taken 10?
No. Illay. All right, people sir. Who have taken 10 committed a mistake, including the papers. Right?
Okay, sir. So, actually,
yes. Sir, so in that case, only one option will be correct, right? The A1.
Right.
Okay, sir. Got
it. So, sir, in future, we don't have to assume that the paper setter wants us to take 10, right? We will always take it as 9.8.
Anytime. Must take it as 9.8.
Sir, so this question's answer, the one which you have drawn on the board, is A, right?
That question is going for bonus.
Yes, sir.
A, B, C, D, say, kya lena
hai? During the test, we were getting the answers in roots, in very bad roots. So,
yes, sir. But I guess it was root 85.
So, that was
sir, however, bonus doesn't justify.
Do you understand what I said?
Yes, sir.
Here, if I assume a perfectly elastic collision and solve, I am not getting this velocity to be 4. So, the question my data given is wrong.
Yes, sir.
That's a mistake.
Okay.
Hence, it goes for a bonus. When is our next lecture?
Tuesday, sir.
Next week. Tomorrow, you have a doubt lecture, I think.
Can we convert tomorrow?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Some idiots have already disconnected. Please communicate to them
sir,
that
we
tomorrow's
have
lecture is a regular lecture. Sun lo jab main bol raha. I speak from the bottom of my belief. When I'm talking, it comes from here. I have a pain. So don't interrupt. Right? Tomorrow's lecture is a regular lecture. Please attend the lecture. It's important. Send it to your friends group. Send it in the group. Keep everybody informed.
Sir, according to you, what?
Pardon?
How was the difficulty of the paper according to you, sir?
I didn't find it to be difficult.
Sir, we have a tutorial of math at 6 p.m. tomorrow.
It's okay, sir. You can keep it. We can see the recording.
Yes, sir.
But no one will attend, then what's the point of recording? Because it's a regular lecture, so everyone will have to join over here.
I guess in the tutorial, it's not only our batch. Other batches are also there.
Yes, sir. You can keep regular lecture.
Yes, sir. Regular lecture is fine.
ये सब adjustment थोड़ी होगा. Some students in tutorial, some students.
But
sir, doubt था sir. ये two VCM sir समझ में नहीं आया किसे भी.
One second. Two VCM. आप class notes घुमाओगे तो दिखाई देगा यार. Adya, are you there in the class? Adya, are you there in the class?
Yes, sir.
Is it your birthday?
Yeah, sir.
Many, many happy returns of the day.
Thank you, sir.
God bless you. You're born April 1st. You're born on April 1st.
Yeah.
Okay. Good
Thank
day.
Thank you, sir.
Sir, so tomorrow's doubt lecture is a doubt lecture.
We cannot adjust so many timetables. Some people have got to do this.
Which doubt will you take?
अगर कुछ है तो लेंगे वरना क्या answer करते?
Some people sir, homework. Will take conceptual doubts or rotational.
Shall, no, not rotation.
So any homework?
नहीं, I need one more lecture for that. Homework देने के लिए एक और lecture की जरूरत नहीं.
Bye sir, thank you sir.
Bye bye.